seven song. We mentioned seven today, that's God's number.
Yes.
It is the seventh day, it's the last day of the year. 70 was the last year for Israel. That was the AD destruction of Jerusalem. Somewhere they have given us a great week of time. You ever heard of it? 6,000 years and then it's over. And then the 7,000th year is the great what? Millennial rest. Sabbath? God always worked with that seven, doesn't he?
Yes.
And folks, let me tell you something. For the past 8 years, God has shown me some things from his word in a chronological way. And guess what? It's right there on the threshold of that 7,000th year. Even closer than you can imagine. For the sake of not trying to guess the day or the hour, I'm not going to tell you that. Because y'all call me a false prophet, and I will be. No man know the day or the hour. But you know what? It didn't include the year, did it? Just like it was in the days of Noah. Did Noah know the year?
Yeah.
How many years was he given?
120.
120. You think he can count?
Yeah.
We got 10. We got 8. We got 5. We got 3. We got 2. We got 1. And guess who dies in that year? Methuselah. I think he can count new to year because he's given to it. And somewhere a great prophet has given us 6,000. I wonder if she's right. I know she's right. Yes, I think she's right. And if you can accept it, Noah knew the day. Remember Genesis 7? Go into the ark, Noah. And guess what? In 7 days, what?
Starting to rain.
It's going to rain. Think it can count? Think that number is important to God? Well, I have 7 songs. Sing to you. I was at a funeral yesterday. I have not seen this rate of death in the past 2-3 years as I have seen in these past 2-3 years. Never seen it. Saints are just falling asleep. My friend Ron Harrison, you know, visiting him and seeing him waste away like that, we were supposed to do a crusade that year.
I'll be ready to hold a boom. Be ready, old boom. I'm getting up out of here.
Okay, Ron, let's just pray. Let's pray, let's pray. He slipped out of here without it. That's a great witness for the Lord.
Amen.
Something is about to happen. We're going to have to know something. I'm going to get a chance this evening to share a little thing about that chronological chart. It'll blow your mind. But we won't do that, y'all. They got the artistry of Charles out there. But we're going to sing. But I can't help myself. I like talking about the Bible and the Word. So please indulge me if I ask you certain questions and then I won't do the singing. I'm going to try to get through all 7 of them and not keep you here too long. This is my precious wife over here. She's my timekeeper. This is Minerva. Y'all meet my wife. Stand up so they can see the baby. She knows I'm mad. She will keep me in check.
Somebody's got to.
Kelsey, what?
Kyla.
Kyla will always keep me in place, too. So let's see what we can do. Let me ask y'all a question. I'm going to talk about two institutions. The first of all of the great institutions that God gave to us was
marriage.
When?
At
the beginning of time. What was the second institution?
Sabbath.
I want to take you from Genesis marriage, which was marriage,
not only to Adam and Eve, but it was a type or a object lesson to the marriage of God the Father to his church. You see, that was also a marriage that was culminated then. And then the Sabbath came, showing God's what? Authority for creation. Then we go from there to the Advent Sabbath. We just mentioned it in the way of saying it's a 7,000 year millennium. So eternity begins with the Sabbath for us. Then the Feast of Tabernacle Marriage. Type will one day be realized in antitype, which is a marriage. It too, if you really assess that very carefully in Leviticus 23, it ends on a Sabbath in heaven. Defying the authority of Lucifer, who establishes the first day as his mark of authority, while at the same time defiling God's woman through the seventh commandment. One question to you. Things that are animate. I ask you this question. Why do things animate and inanimate exist? Now let me ask that question again carefully. Why do things animate and inanimate exist?
To praise God.
I like that. That's a symptom of the things as to why, what caused it.
God created
it. But how, you just said. But my question is, why? See what my wife just said there? Somebody else said that?
Yeah.
It is the love of God that compelled this thing called creation.
Amen.
God is love. And if you've got to be love, it just can't be love. It has to be expressed. You can't say I'm love and don't express it. Creation is an expression of God's love.
Amen.
The only reason why things animate and inanimate exist is because God dared to love. And it culminated in his act of expressing love by creating his bride, Adam and Eve. Adam, as you are a God in type, which I've given you dominion, Eve is your wife. Now the two of you, since I created you, you are my wife. And I express it in love. Five books of the conflict series. What are they? Starting with the first one in chronological order. What's the first word?
God is love.
What's the first word? What's the first word? And what is the first sentence of the patriarchs and prophets?
God is love.
Second book now of the conflict series. Prophets and Kings. What we're doing is outlining an inspired commentary of the Bible from Genesis to
Revelation.
We're talking about here two institutions from Genesis and Revelation, and it was established based on God's love. Third book of the conflict series, Acts of the Apostles. The fourth is
Acts of the Apostles.
And finally,
Great
Controversy. What's the very last sentence of the Great Controversy?
God is love.
All things animate. In fact, I kind of wrote it down. The Great Controversy is ended sin and sinners are no more. The entire universe is clean. One pulse of harmony and gladness beats through the vast creation.
Amen.
From him who created all flow life, flow light, flows gladness throughout the realms of illimitable space, from the minutest atom to the greatest world. There's some big old worlds out there.
make the earth like a little pebble.
To the greatest world, all things, animate and inanimate, in their unshadowed beauty and perfect joy, declare that God is love.
Amen.
If you ever missed that, folks, Jesus said, true or false, keep my commandments.
If you love me,
then keep my commandment. Keep my commandments does a whole lot different from if you love me. Why were we created? Love. It goes into action. If you love me, then keep my commandments. What comes first?
Love.
It's the springboard of every action. Romans 13. It says, count all these commandments. All of them. They're all built on love for your neighbor and love God. So if we're going to get to heaven, we're going to have some love. How do we get it? By beholding him. It's just that simple. Now, with that, let's try to deal with this thing. I want y'all to focus on that seventh commandment. Let me sing a couple of songs. Let's go to Gary with this. I'll take up the mic. You're going to be busy this morning. Going between lapel and the handheld. Let's switch, man. Go ahead.
If we would think Nations feel between you and the serpent.
Because you don't naturally hate him now. You're in love with him. Every time you're going to have to put a little hatred. But you don't naturally have it. I'm going to put enmity between you and the seed of the woman. She wasn't talking about Cain. She wasn't talking about Abel. He wasn't talking about that. He was talking about Jesus. Him coming on the next greater expression of God's love was creation. But the first one was creation. The second one, what? The Son, which is expressed how? No greater love than this. I lay down my life for you. Now you done lost your covering because that was my gown I gave you. You done lost it. You stand before me naked. I got to put some clothes on you. Spiritually, but I got to do it in type and antitype. You go over here and take this lamb. Skin the lamb. The Bible don't say lamb, Charles. It says a noun. It was a lamb. Revelation 13, verse 8. He was a lamb slain from foundation. What kind of animal was that in the Garden of Eden? Lamb. Let me rip his skin off. And Adam is there with his mouth gaping. What did you do this? God, this is totally uncharacteristic of you. That's an innocent lamb. Why did you kill it? What you doing? I'm going to cover you with this lamb's fleece. It's white and pure. You done lost your natural covering, which is what? Light. I'm going to cover you with this lamb's covering. Now, a father looks at you as if you had never sinned. You're just as white as this lamb's fleece. But why? That's me, Adam. 4,000 years from now, that's me. I'm going to give up everything that I had, my righteousness, and I'm going to cover your race with it. And I'm going to stay up on that cross, buck naked, for you. I'm the lamb. That's how much I, what? Love you. That's how much I love you. Take it. Well, we got the fig leaves on. Take them off. What do you know about fig leaves and that milky sap? It is a highly irritant to the skin. Look this term up. You can write it down. Phyto. Photo. Dermatitis. It's legitimate. Phyto is plant. Photo is light or sun. S-O-N. Dermatitis. Not just skin. Irritation. Inflammation of the skin. Phyto, photo, dermatitis. Take the fig leaves off. The problem with that, anytime humans try to do their work to cover themselves and their nakedness, it's highly irritant because the S-O-N is ultraviolet light. You better try to do that filthy work in front of him, you're going to get some serious inflammation. Take them off, son. Take them off, daughter. Let me just put something on you that God can recognize when you stand in his presence.
Amen.
And let's think about how that was done, Gary. More love. More love. Let's talk about him. Go circle.
only Jesus. Oh.